write a policy saying that you want only PAL files, and MediaConf will provide a list of different, in a column about the policy, they will say, oh, it is good or no, it is not good compared to what you decide. In this example, for example, we check a policy, we want only Matroska files, and you can see that the two first ones are MV, MP4, so it is not Matroska, the policy says it is wrong. MP4, it is legal elsewhere, but for you, for example, it is not legal, so we say it is wrong. We want only Matroska, so only the three last lines are okay. An example of report here, it is an implementation report. So if you are testing about why the file is wrong, we inform you with this report about the test we done with this file, and each test has a small name, and we say, okay, is it good or not good? We say how many tests we run about that, and here it is good, all the results are okay. In MediaConf, we provide also a quick link to a MediaInfo report, so you can also get general information about your files. So if you need to quickly check what is the file size, the duration, the bitrate, the frame rate, and so on, it is a classic MediaInfo report for who knows MediaInfo. If you are a bit more curious about what is the content of a file, we also provide a trace feature. The trace feature is good when you know a bit the specification and you are curious about what is wrong in your file, you can check byte per byte what is the content of your files. But if you open the files directly in the file editor, you have only hexadecimal content, which is not so fun to debug. So we provide some help, and we say, okay, this byte, it is, for example, 02, and the meaning of 02, it is an information block, for example. So you can easily dig in your files and see what is wrong, depending on your knowledge. We have a high level knowledge, it is good or not good, that's all. You don't need to know something about the file format. For you, it is not good, you complain to the person who provided the file. But if you are more curious, if you have more knowledge about the file, you can dig up to the byte level in the file format. About policies, as I said before, we provide information about what is compliant to your needs. So for that, we need to know what you need. And we provide an easy way to specify what are your requirements. So for example of a policy editor, it is relatively easy to use. You can add, for example, that you want a specific frame rate. You create a policy, you add a rule, and you has a name, frame rate, okay. You choose the track type. Here it is video, you can choose the field from MediaInfo, it is here frame rate, for example, and you can say, okay, it is more than specific frame rate, or less than, or equal to a specific value. And if you need more constraints, you can add different constraints, and policy is good or not good depending on the list of constraints. Here, in this example, if one of the lines in the policy is wrong, the MediaConf will say that the file is wrong compared to your policy. For the interface, we provide a different interface. We provide a graphical interface, so you download and install the software on your machine, but we also provide a web interface. You only need a browser, and you can check files online. For people who love to do some scripting, we provide a command line, and for the programmers, we provide a REST API. So MediaConf is installed on the server, it is always available, and you call the REST API. We also plan to provide directly a library, so any software, third-party software, will be able to call the library for the programmers. So always the same for our point of view is that we need to adapt ourselves to exactly your level of knowledge. So if you don't use to do some programming, we provide a graphical interface, easy to use. If you are an expert, we provide a library and you can directly access to the library. The same kind of philosophy for output, we can provide a very technical XML output, not easy to read, but more and more easy. With this XML output is readable by any XML editor, and you can process it in your workflow if you need. But if you only need to see if it is okay or not okay, we provide a text output or an HTML output or a PDF output. And actually, we can provide any kind of output because we provide some templates and you can tweak the output exactly as you want. For example, if you want an HTML output or a PDF output with your logo or so on, or with some other information, you can create your own template, and MediaConch will provide information based on this template. So all is tweakable. You can define your policy, you can define how you want to display the report and so on. MediaConch is open source. The license is copyleft license GPLv3 and MPLv2. It relies on different open source libraries, like the main one is MediaInfo. It relies on only other libraries, open source libraries, Qt, SQLite, libevent, and so on. But all is open source in MediaInfo. We have no proprietary code. All is you can copy everything, you can hack everything. So it is a community, open source community. You are welcome. You can hack and provide a copy to your colleague. There is no limitation about that. For the moment, inside the Preformer project, MediaInfo has some priorities. So for the implementation checker, we work mainly for Matroska and Fed V1 and PCM. But as the MediaConch relies on MediaInfo, we can accept any format supported by MediaInfo for the policy checker. So if you want to check that the file is an MXF or JPEG 2000 or a QuickTime movie, or if it is any audio format like BWF and WAV and so on, you can already create some policies about that. We don't check the implementation for this file for the moment, to be able, maybe in the future. But we already provide the policy checker for such files. MediaInfo can also be expanded. For example, we provide and we are working on providing some plugins, and we already have two plugins for PDF. One is for PDF, so we use a plugin from the Vera PDF project, and when it is a PDF file, we detect it and we send the file to the Vera PDF plugin, and we display the report and we say if it is okay or not okay. So you don't need another interface if you need a PDF. You can only configure MediaConch to have such plugin, and you have the same workflow. It is a Matroska video file or a PDF file, it is same, the workflow is exactly the same. Same for TIFF. For the TIFF checking, performance checking, we use the DPF Manager plugin. DPF Manager is a TIFF performance checker. And if you need another file format support, we can create another checker for that. But we actually need to know what you need. We can also do it directly by internal development, not by plugins. We can implement actually everything you need. We have a global knowledge about different file format, Matroska, iMovie, and so on. So it depends of it depends actually on you, on what you need. So we need to know what you need, and maybe we may discuss about what to implement in MediaCrunch. So we are often talking about a video format like FMV1 during the last 3 days. We talk about Matroska, but Matroska may come with other video format, and FMV1 may come from MUV or ABI, not only Matroska. For us, it is not a problem. We can check the FMV1 conformance from every file supported by FMV1. So if it is an MUV, we don't do any conformance checking on MUV for the moment, but we can demux the FMV1 frame, and we can check the FMV1 frame directly from the MUV. So it is not specific to Matroska. And same for Matroska, if you have ABC or AEC in Matroska, we don't do any conformance checking about ABC and AEC, but we do the conformance checking about Matroska. We can also extract some other PDF or TIFF in attachment from Matroska. This is a bit work in progress, but it is something we plan to support very well. So wherever are the data, we can check it. The input is not only files. We can check the files directly on your local hard drive or on your network, but we also can interact with an FTP server, for example, or we can download the file from the internet via HTTP or HTTPS. It is supported. For people having an Amazon S3 storage, it is a bit specific, and we also support such kind of format. So this is versatile, and if you need another access format, let us know, and we can see also what we can do. We provide binaries for Windows, Mac, Linux, and any, normally everything you have, we support it. So if you have a specific distro, let us know, and we can see also what we can do about that. But by default, the three major platforms, Windows, Mac, and Linux, are supported. And we work together with different communities, specifically about Linux. For example, for Ubuntu, since Ubuntu 16.04, there is an easy command for installing MediaConch, apt-get install MediaConch, and that's all you need to do, because MediaConch is directly integrated in the Ubuntu repository. About the standardization part, I think we talked a lot last day and today, so you know everything about that, I can skip this part. That's the IETF book, same. So there, for this project, there are two project leaders, and this is where that they are present here. So me and Dave. And we do different presentations worldwide, everywhere, in the US and in Europe. So more and more people are interested in MediaConch, and we hope we will get even more people in it for that. We also we have created a Matroska research corpus in order to check what exists in the world about the Matroska files. Some specific elements in Matroska are not a lot used, for example the CRC, so the checksum, in order to be sure that the Matroska files are not altered. It is not a lot used, see, it is sometimes used. Some archivists, they love that. And so we check what the different muxer existing in the world have created, and we try to find which one are buggy, and in order to know what are the good mixer, what are the mixer you should not use, for example. And this is what we have now, but in the future we still want to continue with this program. MediaConch is actually sponsored by the Preforma project, and we have some funding up to the end of this year, and we continue to work on it in order to have some better handling of huge collections, better user interface for whoever, in order to have something easy to have. We can try some statistics, so if you provide, for example, all your collection, we want to say, to be able to say what you have with Matroska, what you have with FFB1, what you have with ABC, and so on. We are still working to standardize Matroska and FFB1. We want to add more performance tests, so because currently we don't test the whole Matroska specification, but it is on the way. And we try to have MediaConch library integrated a bit everywhere. So for people having the Archivmatica, for example, MediaConch will be directly integrated in Archivmatica. So there is nothing to do, only using Archivmatica, and you'll get you will have your performance checker. We are also working to in order to have a fixer for basic fixer, in if it is relatively easy to fix the bugs we can find in the Matroska or FFB1, and if it is not playable, for example, we can try to fix the files before you put in the archive. So this year, 2016, it is okay, it is funded, but next year and the next after that, what we will do? Actually, this is open source, so everyone is free to participate. So it is driven by user requests. So you can, depending of what you can do, you can develop, you can provide some documentation, and or you can sponsor any other development. What we are thinking about, like kind of features, is to have some better integration about other formats, for example MXF. So a lot of people have MXF, and we want to be able to test the implementation of MXF, because MXF, it is a bit awful, lot of different mixer, lot of bugs in different mixer. It's sometimes difficult. Oh, this player can play it, but this one, no, why? So, we want to be able to say, oh, yes, you will be able to play this file with this player, but with this other player it will not be the case. For example, it is a policy, because the file may be correct, but the player may be wrong, and sometimes you want not only to have a good file, conform to specification, but maybe playable everywhere. So you can have some policies about that. An example of policy, yesterday or Monday, we talked about AS07. We put that such kind of policy in MediaConch. For example, AS07 is a restriction about the MXF. Not all the world MXF is authorized in AS07, and we can say, oh, this is legal, but not for AS07, so this is a policy. We hope to be able to integrate over different checkers in MediaConch. There are some good performance checkers, like BWF MetaEdit. It is a very good project, because I developed it, actually. another project is QCTools. So QCTools is a bit different because it analyzes the decoded frame. This is not a conformance checker, it is not a stream checker, the decoded frame. Dave can talk about it without problem. You don't want? Okay. We can add a better integration in your workflow if we know it. Any kind of idea you can have. Do you have some time, or? Yeah.
But no, we're behind, but. Next speaker.
So there are some examples in the slide I will provide. So quickly, but I can provide a live demo also. If you want to test MediaConch, you don't need to install anything. You go on MediaConch online and you can check everything you want. So it's relatively easy. You choose which policy you want. This is not mandatory, but we can say, oh, I want this standard. Which one? Yeah. Let's go. You can choose if you want to upload a file, or if you want to check a .NET file, or if you want to check the files on the server. On the server, we can have links to your repository, for example. So we have different files, MV, and so on. And for this policy, they are all wrong. And you can check why it is wrong, actually. Oh, it is wrong because the width is not the expected one. So you have a list of the policy you want, and it was expected to have 720 for the width, and it is the wrong one. You can know it very quickly. So you can have a media info report. Oh, it is there. So very classic media info. We saw it several times today and on Monday. You can download them also. It's also possible. If you are curious, you can check a trace about that. What is wrong in the file? It is byte per byte. What is the wrong file, the wrong thing? Or if you're just curious about how it is implemented directly in the file. We are not limited about Matroska. Even on the media trace feature, for example, if you have an MOV, if you are curious about what is the content of an MOV, you can check the MOV atoms, and you can go very far about that, exactly byte per byte or bit per bit. Well, different information. So it is easy to use, I hope. If you have some remarks, let me know. So with the online version, you can test online files. You can take an example. A lot of people talk about GPX. You can check GPX too. Archive.org. Dave, your name?
No.
You are everyone. GPX sample file? Okay, your name.
Yeah, everybody should share more sample files.
So, I copy the link. And we check the file.
If enough people share, then maybe.
It is added.
Yeah,
Matroska
says.
There is currently no policy about GPX, but you can add one if you want. It is valid because actually we don't test it, so we will change it. That we say it is not applicable because we don't test GPX. But you can have the media info report about GPX. So there were a lot of talks about the color primaries and so on, so it is available in media info. If you are curious, you have a trace of a GPX too. So it is not limited to Matroska or FLV1. We tried to cover all the file formats. But not this done in one shot. We need some time for that. Okay, do you have some questions?
Hi. The UK DPP sponsored media for some stations,
BBC, UK DPP profile is supported by Media Info. BBC did not directly sponsor the support, but so they helped me about that. Yes.
I was just curious if they ever approached you, because it just seems like an implementation checker for ACE11 would work very well with this.
We can work on it. Actually, for DPP, it is relatively easy. It is already supported in MediaInfo, so we only need to add the specific tools about that. So this will not be something very expensive. Because the DPP support was sponsored by another company, so we already provide the data. But the company accepted to make open source only the analysis of the file and not the check. The check is proprietary in that case. So we need to make it in an open source form directly in MediaCrunch. This is not the biggest part. Yeah. So we could add a DPP implementation checker. So we can get in touch and see what we can do about that.
About the policy checker, is there a way to extend it to a broader scope? For instance, if you want to check, I want a valid DPX file, but in my folder I want to check that all DPX files have the same bit depth and the same resolution, and this is valid if I have these relative conditions.
This is not currently implemented, so currently it is file per file, it is independent. But this is a feature we plan to add. We hope to be able to add that before the end of the year, but maybe beginning of next year.
Yeah. Sort of a question, but where does the line, where do you draw the line between, because I know you talked about QC tools analyzes the video, where do you draw the line between what you say is a policy checker looking at the data and the actual QC line?
Okay.
I'm not
quite
sure where the line is.
For MediaCrunch, the purpose is to analyze the bit stream, where, so bit per bit, without decoding the data. So it is not a quality analysis of your content. We only check that technically it is good or wrong. This is the line for MediaCrunch. But there are some requests about having a global product. So in order also to test the decoded frame, and this part is QC tools. So MediaConch will not touch to the decoded frame. What Dave talked about the weird frames wrongly digitalized, this is not the purpose of MediaConch. MediaConch, it is conformance checking about the exact bitstream compared to the file format. But we want to have a plugin with such things like QC tools. No more questions? Or? Is it okay? Anyone else? Okay.
Thank you.
Another question.
Another question. Ah. Our advertising, November 23, the Quipoga project makes an experience workshop. Do you want to be there also in presenting the stage media punch in
In November, there will be a performer meeting, yes. So, Steve, your turn.